Today I'm going to show you the simple art of wiring a single pole switch. I'm doing that exact thing right now in a portion of my basement. So I'll use that example to talk you through the types of wire you need, how to connect those wires in the electrical boxes, and I'll show you some common rookie mistakes to avoid in the process. The single pole switch with light is the most straightforward wiring you can do, and you'll be able to use some of the knowledge you originally gained in high school physics to help make sense of it. You may remember schematic diagrams for circuits. Circuits start with a power source, like a battery, and electricity, or specifically electrons, move from the hot side of the power source, travel along a conducting wire to something like a light bulb, and return to the other side of the power source. The driving force behind this flow is the buildup of electrons on one terminal, but not the other. When given a pathway away from that buildup, electrons are like an introvert at a house party. They just got to get out of there. Electrons take a path away from the negative pole and towards the positive pole if one is available. Now, if there's a break in the circuit, if it's opened by, say, a switch, the electrons have no way to get to the other side, and so the light goes out and the electrons no longer move. Close the circuit again, and the electrons continue movement and light the bulb up again. It's a little bit more complicated with the alternating current running to a closet like this, but the wiring can be thought of in the same way. Just replace the battery in the diagram for the power from the utility company feeding into the electrical box for distribution throughout the house. For any one circuit, like the 15 amp circuit that'll be supplying power to this light, a copper conducting wire in black insulation supplies the power, and another copper wire in white insulation completes the circuit by giving electrons a path to return to the electrical panel. Your home wiring looks a little different from the schematic diagram because these wires run right next to each other in one protective outer jacket, and this is called Romex. A third wire called the ground wire, which isn't insulated, also comes in the Romex, and it serves a protective function to allow another pathway for electrons if there's a problem with the circuit. You're going to have two 14-2 Romex wires in your switch electrical box, one running between the breaker box and the switch, and the other running between the switch and the light. So let's start wiring up that switch. As I show you this, please bear in mind that I am a science teacher by trade, not an electrician. Please consult a professional on anything that doesn't make sense. Having said that, be sure to drop a comment below with any questions or suggestions you might have, and I'll try to answer them. First things first, before any wiring project, flip the breaker for the circuit you'll be working with. That'll keep you safe and keep your hair from frizzing out, and keep you from smelling like barbecue when the job's done. The single pole switch is mild-mannered with a friendly disposition and has three screw terminals. One for a line wire from the breaker box, one for a load wire off to the light, and one for the ground wire. The tricky thing about single pole switches for DIYers is oftentimes figuring out what to do with the white wires. So that's where we're going to start. If you think of it like an outlet, then you might be looking for a place to attach the white neutral wire to the switch. The thing is, it doesn't attach to the switch. All the switch is doing is opening and closing the circuit, and this only needs to happen in one location in the electron path, and that's on the black hot wire. Therefore, since the white wire simply provides a return pathway for electrons, you just connect the white wires together in the electrical box with a wire nut without attaching it to the switch. Twist until the nut is super tight and give it a few extra twists. You connect the ground wires in a similar fashion. Start by cutting a roughly 6-inch piece of bare copper wire and connect it to the green screw terminal on the switch. Then take the ends of all three ground copper wires, and you can simply twist them together and forego the wire nut. They don't need protected, but you can certainly add a wire nut to hold them if you like. If you're still watching this video, I'm hoping that you find it useful. If so, I'd appreciate it if you gave it a big thumbs up. It really does help. Thank you so much. Let's get back to it. This leaves us with only two black wires in the box, one coming from the breaker and the other coming from the light. Connect the black hot wire from the breaker box to the bottom screw terminal and the black wire from the light to the top screw. The single pole switch closes the circuit in the on position, allowing electricity or electrons to pass through the lights, completing the circuit. In the off position, the switch opens the circuit, cutting off the flow of electrons and turning off the light. From here, hooking up the light is cake. The light will most likely have three stranded wires, black, white, and bare copper ground. And your 14-2 Romex that ends at the light contains black, white, and bare copper ground. Attach black to black, white to white, and bare copper ground to bare copper ground, and you're in business. Do keep in mind that these connections must be secure to avoid complications. So if you're using wire nuts, ensure that you have about an 1/8 inch more stranded wire exposed than the solid wire, since the stranded wire will end up twisting around the solid wire Romex. Make sure you have the right size wire nut for the job. Feed in the wire tips and twist like you did when attaching the solid Romex in the electrical box. Or you could go the fancy route and use my new favorite thing, lever nuts by Wago. Holy smokes, these things are slick. The Wago lever nut can connect solid and stranded wire, and it's super easy. Now, I am not sponsored by the Wago company, but if they did want to start a relationship, I'd consider it. There's a strip gauge on the back of the Wago, so you know exactly how much insulation to strip off. For both stranded and solid wire, just lift the lever, feed the wire all the way in, then flip the lever back down. These wires aren't going anywhere. And the back of the Wago is clear, so you can turn it over and see for yourself that the wires are in the correct position. And if something changes and you need to remove a wire, just flip up the lever and it comes right out. They're pretty incredible, and I've got a link in the description if you're interested. Now flip the breaker back on and give the light a shot. If it works, great. If not, seek medical attention immediately. And after seeing this video, if you feel like I've earned your subscription, you can drill that Man Cycle logo. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.